Let's begin this morning in the manner of friends with a moment of silent worship. Good morning. Friends, I'd like to introduce Jim Wright, the clerk of our Board of Trustees, who will begin our commencement exercises this morning with a reading. Jim.
Good morning, friends. The reading for today is a poem by Michelle Alexander, which she wrote for Barack Obama's inauguration. The title of the poem is Praise Song for the Day. Each day we go about our business, walking past each other, catching each other's eyes or not, about to speak or speaking. All about us is noise. All about us is noise and bramble, thorn and din, each one of our ancestors' tongues. Someone is stitching up a hem, darning a hole in a uniform, patching a tire, repairing the things in need of repair. Someone is trying to make music somewhere with a pair of wooden spoons on an oil drum, with cello, boombox, harmonica, voice. A woman and her son wait for the bus. A farmer considers changing the changing sky. A teacher says, take out your pencils, begin. We encounter each other in words, words spiny or smooth, whispered or declaimed, words to consider, consider, reconsider. We cross dirt roads and highways that mark the will of someone and then others who said, I need to see what's on the other side. I know there's something better down the road. We need to find a place where we are safe. We walk into that which we cannot see. Say it plain that many have died for this day. Sing the names of the dead who brought us here, who laid the train tracks, raised the bridges, picked the cotton and the lettuce, built brick by brick the glittering edifices they would then keep clean and work inside of. Praise song for struggle. Praise song for the day. Praise song for every hand-lettered sign, the figuring it out at kitchen tables. Some live by love thy neighbor as thyself. Others by first do no harm, or take no more than you need. What if the mightiest word is love? Love beyond marital, filial, national, love that casts a widening pool of light, love with no need to preempt grievance. In today's sharp sparkle, this winter air, anything can be made, any sentence begun, on the brink, on the brim, on the cusp. Praise song for walking forward in that light.
Thank you, Jim. Good morning, friends. My name is Craig Sellers. I'm the head of school here at Friends Central, and I have the good fortune of greeting you this morning and welcoming you to our 176th commencement ceremony, honoring the fine young people of the class of 2021. Feel the love. On behalf of our Board of Trustees, our dedicated and talented faculty and staff, our accomplished alumni, and most importantly, on behalf of the extraordinary members of the class of 2021, welcome to our school and welcome to these commencement exercises. As we close this particularly historic year, it seems so appropriate for all of us here to welcome those attending via Zoom this morning. And yes, I'm looking right at our webcam, and I'm told that more than 100 people are joining us via Zoom this morning. Welcome, we're so pleased you are here as well. It's terrific to have us gathered. It's exciting to be together in this safe and responsible, and dare I say, moving back to normal fashion. So I'm just gonna keep going with that momentum this morning and say thank you to our buildings and grounds, our safety, and our tech crews who helped to make our campus as beautiful as it is safe and who make all this live stream logistics look easy so that we can enjoy a great morning together. Thank you, friends. Thank you to our faculty and staff who consistently gave their all this year. Amidst historic circumstances, you have inspired this class to heights they could not have imagined without your kindness, your caring, and your passion, and your willingness to be just as committed to excellence delivered via the internet as excellence in your classroom right here on campus. Thank you, faculty and staff. Thank you to Beth Johnson, Bill Kennedy, Tom McFarlane, and Mary Claire D'Orazio, the centerpieces of our indomitable upper school team, for your determination, your drive, and your leadership, all laced with love and optimism. And friends, if you are wondering who to thank this morning for the sun coming out right as our graduating class was walking in, it's that group. Thank you so much. Thank you to the families who had the generosity of spirit and the collective determination to lift up our community compact all year and collaborate not just when it was easy, but when it was hard. We know you have provided a life-changing education to your children that will last a lifetime and that you will see in subtle and profound ways forever. Thank you. Thank you to the families. And to the 101 simply extraordinary athletes, artists, and academics who comprise the class of 2021, I have two thoughts before introducing the speakers you have selected from your class. First, for everyone here, our community has come so far as we think about our collective safety. But I still want to say, in what I hope will be the last time any Friends Central School head has to say this in more than another 100 years, thank you for wearing your masks this morning during our commencement ceremony. This simple act of caring reminds us that we are connected, reminds us that we can behave in ways that elevate the health and safety of others, and provides a powerful model of individual responsibility that gives us hope for the future. And secondly, directly to our graduates, everyone here today is filled with pride about you, your accomplishments, and the many, many beautiful ways you have let your life speak. We have come to know you as such exceptional young people who we believe will peacefully transform the world. We are in many, many ways simply in awe of you and your accomplishments. Our ceremony began today with silent worship, which encourages us to be fully present right here, right now. For years and years, we have consciously, intentionally designed student and faculty voices to be at the center of this ceremony, and we will continue that tradition this morning. We can be sure that each of our featured speakers will bring us further into understanding the meaning of a Friends Central education. So I would now like to invite Liam Gishter and Ryan Lynch to speak with us this morning. You should know that Liam and Ryan were selected for this honor by members of the graduating class of 2021. We will begin with Liam.
Good morning, everyone. It is an incredible honor and privilege to be one of your commencement speakers today. I know traditionally, the commencement speech is delivered by the grades valedictorian. Since this is a Quaker school, however, that is not how we approach the commencement speech. I bring this up because I want to make sure everyone is aware that I am not the school's valedictorian. I am surrounded and awestruck by the intelligence, talent, and hard work of my peers. I'm incredibly grateful and humbled that despite this, I am standing before you today. With that in mind, I'd like to make sure you all get the right idea about how incredible our class is. First, I think it's safe to say we are perseverant. Not every grade has to apply to colleges at the same time as a global pandemic, a national lockdown, a call to protest, a year ripe with racial violence, and a terrorist attack against the capital of the nation. We certainly hope that our children will not have to experience that, and neither will our children's children. We are a driven class. I don't think there was any doubt about that when the senior committee and student council struggled tirelessly and brought a sense of normalcy and tradition to a virtual senior year. And they were not alone in their accomplishments. I mean, after all, we all survived 8-hour Zoom days without flunking school. We managed to get an education while sometimes sleeping through our classes with our cameras off. So I can easily say that the class of 2021 is adaptable. But many people always put the time and effort in, and some did to an extent I thought was genuinely impossible. Some toiled over every paper, completed every math problem, worked hours upon hours in front of our screens, even after a day of nothing but time in front of a computer. And there is no word for that commitment that I can think of other than passion. So I can faithfully say that our class is passionate. But of course, there's more than academics. What would this grade be? What would this school be? Without the amazing athletes who grace this campus? Without the incredible artists, actors, musicians, engineers, mathematicians, scholars, scientists, inventors, advocates, and leaders who are dead set on changing the world? One simply needs to walk around campus to see the many, many ways that the class of 2021 is talented. Although I'd have to say, where I see the biggest talent in this class is in our grace. We learned, albeit the hard way, not to be daunted by change. Those of us who lived in the States managed to transition between normalcy to virtual classes, to harder virtual classes, to live classes, back to virtual classes, and then to live classes again, and did it in a constantly changing and uncertain world. And I'd like to shout out the students from abroad who managed to complete classes in a completely different time zone, isolated from the support of the rest of the school community. We miss you, and we wish you could be here with us. Your commitment and dedication is inspiring. I'd also like to mention the continuous struggles and sacrifices that our teachers, administration, and support staff endured to give us the best possible experience and education, both online and in person. Equally, we are so fortunate to have the unconditional love and support of our families, caregivers, and friends. How lucky we are to have been surrounded by true role models through the years. For what we have achieved, we are indebted to you all. But forgetting coronavirus for a second, we moved into the high school at a time when there wasn't a cafeteria, when we had to get our meals from an old gymnasium. Something that, in light of what we've been through, really doesn't feel like that much of a big deal, but at the time it was. We had to cope with multiple controversies that not only affected the school and every one of us, but were also featured in the outside press. Our entire high school experiences have been challenged constantly, and with each challenge, we have kept our heads up high and have moved forward. And frankly, every single one of us could be up here giving this speech, considering that. I am not trying to get down on myself, and I am not trying to be self-deprecating. I try my best, and I like to think that I can get rewarded for that sometimes. But I have been so daunted by the idea of giving this speech, because how could I, or any single one of us for that matter, possibly encapsulate the incredible wisdom of this class in a 5 to 10 minute speech. Every single one of us is perseverant, driven, adaptable, passionate, talented, and graceful. And I hope you feel that your time and experiences at this school reflect that. I have no doubt that each of us will go into the world the same way we went through high school. We will experience hard times and be forced to cope with a tough world, and we will persevere. We will see the ways in which things can and should change, and will be driven to change them. We will find ourselves in situations and settings that we couldn't have expected, so we will adapt. We will hurt, and we will suffer, but we won't let that stop our passions. And our passion will reveal our incredible talent, which we will share with the world. And we will do it all with our heads high, our shoulders back, and grace in our every step. To the class of 2021, I am grateful to have been able to share my high school experience with you, and I wish all of us a wholehearted congratulations. We have earned it.
Thank you, Liam. Friends, Ryan Lynch will speak with us next. Ryan?
Hi, my name is Ryan. That was how I used to introduce myself when I first came to Friends Central. At my old school, this was necessary because many students did not know each other, let alone know each other's names. In the beginning, this place was definitely a bit of a culture shock. Some of my peers would greet me with an embrace in the morning, not just a hug, but with the biggest squeeze. I have to be honest, my initial reaction was, why is this person touching me? But soon, I began to need those hugs in the morning to get through my day. These hugs came to represent the genuineness I felt in the spirit of this school and in the spirit of our class. On this beautiful day, I want to give a ginormous congratulations and the biggest air hug to every single graduate here. This is our day to be proud. Not only proud, but at peace. We have endured some hard times at a very young age, like the virus that shall not be named, the college process, mental health, racial equality, online school, and worst of all, senioritis. We have had a major glow up in both our looks as well as within ourselves. I hope I can speak for everyone when I say we are not the same people we were entering Friends Central. We are no longer the little kids that do not know the hardships of life. Now, we are young adults who have a lot more living to do, but in this moment to celebrate, we need to celebrate how far we have come. As we come into ourselves, a significant aspect of life is learning what guides you and keeps you grounded. For some, their guide might be astrology. For me, it's puzzles. Let me explain. As infants, each day we learned something new. Whether it was crawling, talking, or figuring out how to sneak out of our cribs while our parents slept. We did not learn these skills overnight. They took time. But after many failed attempts, we took our first steps, we said our first words, and we conquered getting over that crib gate. These experiences began to develop the puzzle pieces of our individual personalities, pieces like resilience and compassion. As we grew older, new pieces began to emerge. Graduates and audience members, raise your hand if you would say you're a spontaneous person. Thank you. Now raise your hand if you're the type of person who enjoys planning ahead. Thank you. Now raise your hand if you're somewhat in the middle. Thank you. Now that we all recognize a difference among ourselves, allow me to tell you what I see. The puzzle piece that we all share is a positive outlook. On the day of our senior picnic, I was sitting in the atrium of our science and math department building. We like to call the FCC in the building with a bunch of windows. About 10 of my peers came into the building drenched. I do not know who brought the water buckets that day, but they were definitely being put to good use. As the dripping students squeaked by, I could not help but notice the pure joy on their faces. Seeing them reminded me of the carefree spirit that radiates through us all. This beautiful essence is what makes the class of 2021 so special. Please hold on to this piece of yourself as you continue to frame your ever-evolving puzzle. As I close, you might think this is a little silly, but I have a 12-year-old brother, hey Tommy, who has made my family Disney fanatics. I would like to share some parting advice from Disney. As one of the new kids in 10th grade, I know firsthand how challenging a new environment can be. My first day of school, my schedule read M22. And I remember thinking, how can a room number have a letter? After getting adjusted to the locations of my classes and how Friend Central operated, I took a step back and realized that every new situation brings a myriad of new and exciting things. As we learned from Finding Nemo, you need to just keep swimming, and eventually you'll learn how to flow with the tide. My next piece of advice is from the film Up. Even though at times it might feel terrifying to step out of your comfort zones, we've learned from high school it is necessary. Join that club, apply for that leadership position, go to that party. You never know who you will meet and what might come out of that experience. Adventure is out there. Soak it all up. Lastly, in honor of our amazing yearbook and the yearbook committee, I just had to include a bit of advice from Toy Story. It may be hard to find new friends at first, and you may have to start your sentences and conversations with, "Hi, I am." Don't feel discouraged. Remember, you have a home at Friend Central with people who already know how incredible you are. Remember all of the memories you have made here at home. Remember, you will always have a friend in me, have a friend in us. In the true fashion of Gen Z to remember this day, I would like to take a selfie of us. Everyone smile big.
Ready?
I'll send it in the group chat. This has been such an honor. Thank you to the faculty and students for giving me this opportunity. I love you all. Please never change. And as a teacher once told me, I can't wait to see what you all will become. Thank you.
Thank you, Liam. Thank you, Ryan. That was extraordinary. Just wonderful. And anticipating our communications department, I'm sure they're going to want a copy of that, Ryan. Thank you. Friends, moving us on this morning, our assistant upper school principal, Bill Kennedy. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Bill. I'm waiting for my glow up. It seems appropriate that such a fabulous class should hear from not one, but two faculty speakers this morning. I am honored to introduce the first of these presenters, Alex McDonald. Having himself graduated from Friends Central School in 1987, Alex sat on this very terrace just three short decades ago. In the team photo, he's in the third row, just left of center, looking ahead to Swarthmore College, where he studied history and played basketball. Alex met Dawn, his future bride, during their first year orientation, although it took her a few semesters to convince him that she was the one. And he kept in touch with FCS, joining Aaron Selko, another alumni parent here today, to coach JV baseball during his senior year in college. Upon graduation, Alex planned to teach for a few years, but happily for us, he's never left. He just got busy, then busier. He has done and continues to do so much here. A teacher's teacher, he has taught social studies and history in all three divisions. He has been a patient and innovative technologist, a supportive and knowledgeable coach and advisor. He ably directs the summer programs and does terrific work as the 11th grade dean. Kieran, an up-and-coming expert on the McDonald's, describes his dad as wise, genuine, caring, a teacher who wants to empower his students. Of course, Kieran also said his dad was irresistibly handsome, so perhaps he wasn't the most objective source. In all seriousness, though, Alex has been a gift to Friends Central School, and those of us lucky enough to work with him, and we all work with him. Also, I should mention here at the end that Don and Alex are the proud parents of five Friends Central graduates, a rare and remarkable achievement. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Alex McDonald.
Irresistibly handsome, I like that. I want to thank the Speaker Selection Committee, Craig Sellers, Beth Johnson, the board, and my colleagues, and of course, the class of 2021, for the privilege of speaking to all of you today. And thank you, Bill, again, for the introduction. When Craig called me a few months ago and asked me to speak, of course I said yes, but what to say? He was quite firm. I only had 5 minutes. I don't want to be guilty of empty platitudes, so I hesitate to give advice. And clearly, I have to cut right to the chase because my time is already ticking. Yet forgive me, because I'm going to give some advice anyway, because for a few more moments, I'm still your teacher. I want to share with you three ideas. The first, go out and peacefully transform the world is one very obvious and appropriate thing to say today. And of course, do that. But let the world transform you too. I've learned I can be wrong. I can hurt others. I can also hurt others when I don't even think I'm wrong. I can see I may mean no harm, or I can listen and change. Learn and grow, and realize it's okay to let experience shape you. I'm not always right. You're not always right. So peacefully transform the world, but let the world transform you too. The second thing I want to say, cultivate wisdom. Friends Central has wanted you to be smart. But more importantly, and I think you heard this last night at the baccalaureate, we've wanted you to be wise. In this information age, Karl Marx's dictum, knowledge is power, has never been more true. You have knowledge, and you're going to have access to power. Will you use it wisely? I sure hope so, because we've left you some big problems. Some say this information age is coming to an end, and we're entering an ominously entitled an age of reckoning. You have had, and will continue to have, the privilege of an education. How will you use it? What's the difference, anyway, between intelligence and wisdom? One way to think about it is the notion that wisdom is intelligence informed by an abiding empathy. I want to explore just for a moment some of the things Friends Central has had you think about coupled with this notion of wisdom. A lower school tradition in your time, some of you experienced, was the reading and acting out of the book Stone Soup, which teaches the notion that together we can nourish ourselves in ways we cannot do alone. Another lower school practice was feedback sessions, in which you learned how to share your feelings and make amends. It seems to me that developing empathy is something we take very seriously. When this graduating class was in fifth grade, the first fifth grade at the lower school since the early 1980s, you started the garden that is figuratively and literally blossomed into a core component of the lower school program. I would suggest that getting things to grow is both a metaphor for and a lesson in empathy. In middle school, service sat and still sits right in the middle of the school week, every single week. And many of you built relationships with elders and children that made a difference in their lives, and just as importantly, in yours. In upper school, you stood on City Avenue in witness to the importance of Black lives and in solidarity with the students at Stoneman Douglas. Some of you worked with Daroff Tutoring, others of you did service committee, others served the community on student council. You joined affinity groups, mental health clubs, sister circle, brothers squared, and more. And while these are all certainly head things, they're really heart things. My point is that even though we cultivate the intellect, hopefully our biggest lessons at Friends Central have little to do with being smart. I worry we live in a culture where intelligence is valued above wisdom. And that's not good, because just as honesty without love is brutal, intelligence without wisdom is arrogant. A couple of weeks ago, I mailed about 25 of you letters you had written yourself at the end of fifth grade. What did you tell yourself? If I can be your teacher, one more moment. Sometime this week, write a letter to your future self. What you tell yourself is core to who you are. What's core about you right now that you still want to be present in 5, 10, and 20 years? I encourage you all to do it, because there'll be wisdom there. Again, what makes for wisdom is intelligence tempered by empathy. And if we really want to transform the world, we have to understand and share the feelings of others. The third thing I want to say is simply, thank you. I've known this class for a long time. I've known some of you since you were 4. I taught many of you in fifth grade. Special shout out to 5Z. Again in 9th grade, 11th grade, and 12th grade. Some of you I had the privilege of teaching 3 times. I loved teaching you. I've seen you grow up. I've watched your success on stage, in the classroom, on the courts, fields, and track. You've made your mark on me and on this place for good. So again, the 3 things I wish to say: let the world change you, cultivate empathy so that you can be wise, and again, thank you. I want to let you know that as you leave here, and in a few months, leave home, that you're really ready for the next step. It's time. And that also means it's time for us to let you go. So with that, our hand is slipping for yours, but it's waved in farewell. Thank you.
Thank you, Alex. Friends, Beth Johnson, our upper school principal and assistant head of school for student life, will introduce our next speaker.
I haven't grown since Friday, sorry. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. We're so glad to see you. And I just want to say one more time, congratulations to the class of 2021. It's my pleasure to introduce our next speaker, Jim Rosengarten, or as I call him, Brother Jim. He has been a Friends Central teacher of history and sometimes English for over 20 years. He is also the father of two graduates and of Ruby Kaufman Rosengarten, a member of the class of 2021. Even though all of us could say wonderful things about Jim, I asked his daughter Ruby to describe her dad. She shared a number of adjectives, but among them she said reliable, fair, thoughtful, loving, caring. She also said, he's funny too. But she said he always tells the same jokes over and over. Craig said, ouch. Also, she said, you know, he's been wearing the same clothes since he started at Friend Central many years ago. But more importantly, if she were standing here, she would want to thank her dad for connecting her to Friend Central School. She said, my dad made it possible for me to come here, and he has gotten me through. I feel lucky, she said. I just want to say to Jim, I think students would say they feel lucky if they had you as a teacher. And we look forward to hearing from you this morning. Friends, I present to some and introduce to others, Jim Rosengarten.
Thank you, Ms. Beth, for that lovely introduction. And thank you, Ruby. Lunch is on me. And thank you to Mr. Sellers for this invitation to speak. And thank you to my colleagues, whom I am honored to teach alongside, and to whom my wife, Ida, and I thank in particular for all you have given to Ruby and all of our daughters. And to the class of 2021, I am truly honored to speak to you today. Mr. McDonald just spoke some beautiful words of wisdom to you. One of the things he said is that honesty without love is brutal. I want to talk to you ever so briefly, and in 5 minutes, about love. Love, it seems to me, is what drives all of us. We desire to be loved more than I would say anything else. What drives us, motivates us, our passions themselves are really all about us wanting to experience love, to step into the light of love and bathe in its warmth. And that all sounds good, I suppose, but I really don't know if that's right. I think that life is really all about figuring out what love is. While I admit to reading a lot of works about love, while I admit to being touched by what many people have said about it, the reality is that I think I learn most about love by seeing the outward expressions of it. Those outward expressions of love are usually actions, especially the subtle ones, that teach me more about what it means to love than any reading or talking can do. And it strikes me that you all have been loving quite a bit in your time here. Just thinking of this past, hopefully utterly unique year makes me think about the outward expressions of love that you have demonstrated. A few months after the pandemic locked us all down, George Floyd was murdered, sparking a response to racial injustice in this country that is still reverberating today, and with your continued help, will hopefully reverberate for years to come. You created a new club, the Brotherhood, partly in response to this. You spoke passionately, openly, and even vulnerably about race and equity issues, hopefully helping yourselves, but certainly helping our community as we continue to try to create a more equitable and welcoming school. That has been an inspiring outward expression of love. Over your time here, and even in this hopefully forever unique year, you threw yourself into your passions, creating beautiful music with instruments and your amazing voices, putting on musicals and dramas and singing Valentines, outward expressions of love. You've shown spirit and dedication on the courts and in the fields, as you showed us your passion for sports and for spirited and joyful athleticism. You've continued a mock trial tradition with your incredible talent, and you've even discovered pulsars in the heavens, outward expressions of love. You've found creative ways to keep traditions alive in virtual assemblies, to be rather tireless leaders of student council, sister circle, brother square, focus, world press, honor council, and so many more of the myriad clubs whose value you held up, outward expressions of love. And then there are all the subtle ways you have outwardly expressed your love, ways reflected in part during the senior citations a few nights ago. Of course, your class, like all classes, has had its share of conflict, but you've also shown great support and encouragement to each other. You've held each other's successes up. You've used your wit in classes to help create learning communities. You make fun of each other and laugh with each other in ways that demonstrate how well you know each other. You have shown each other kindness, both in the gentle ways you have been with each other, but also in the ways you have called each other out to be better. These are the perhaps more subtle, but equally important outward expressions of love. And love is creative. It has to be, can't help itself. So as you continue pursuing your passions, figuring out what you want to do with your life, you will find new ways to create, sometimes bigger and more dramatic ways to create. The obvious example of that creativity of love is caregivers and their children. You graduates are all the fruits of the actions of love your caregivers have tried to express. I have been utterly humbled by my experience of being Ruby's and her sister's father. While they are the greatest outward expression of love my wife and I will ever create, the humble part comes in knowing that I only had a little to do with all that. So be nice to your caregivers these days as we celebrate you with joy and gratitude and a bit of befuddlement as we try to figure out how this all happened. And know that there are many, many ways to have your love create something. Your teachers and I cannot wait to see what you do, to sit back and watch. And that might be my final word: watching, seeing, discovering those outward expressions of love is worth doing. It makes you more creative, more bold, and more grateful for all things around you. And we need all the help we can get to do the creative work of love that needs to be done. The loving work of making the world a better place and letting ourselves be made better by others too. So as you go out into the world, be open to letting it change you, to letting it teach you. Find those outward expressions of love and let them create a sense of gratitude that not only will strengthen you, but also guide you into the habit of creating love. We've seen you start doing it already, and we look forward to you teaching us more. Congratulations, and truly, thank you.
Thank you, student speakers. Thank you, faculty speakers. Can we give them one more round of applause for us? Class of 2021, we're at that moment. Are you feeling ready? Got it. We will now award the diplomas. Will the class of 2021 please rise?
To do the Jumbotron first. Keep smiling. Keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure. Y'all remember that Roberta Flack tune? Yeah. That's what friends are for. Y'all don't know Roberta Flack though, right? In good times and bad times, I hear you. I'll be on your side forevermore. Look at them, they're just looking at us. They don't know the song. That's what friends are for. I just wanted to sing that to you so you know. I'm gonna miss you. Gonna miss you. And you really can count on me for sure. Count on me for sure. At this time, I want to draw your attention to the Jumbotron. Going to wait for the switch. Can I keep going? There are some students who are not able to be with us in person this morning. They are with their families in China, having learned from there all year. We're going to award their diplomas first, and Bill Kennedy will come and read the names. He might sing, too. He might sing.
Go for it, Bill.
I'm going to do you the great favor of not singing. All right. Our first recipient is Yifei Chen. Next, Yixing Hu. Bella Liu. Next is Sally Su. Yina Wang. Next, Ellie Yang. There's Ellie. And finally, Twyla Zhang. Congratulations.
Now back in person, Liam Jacob Gishter. Turn and pose, there we go. Here we go, Ryan Renee Lynch. Mr. Sellers, did you want to take off your mask or are you leaving it on? Okay. Zoe Jean Albertson. Benjamin Keith Allen. Leia Ruth Anderson. Yeah. Rory Aria Anderson. Hallie Mayjean Bender. William Charles Bosman. Jordan Alexa Brady. Dylan Maxwell Buckholz. Han H. Choi. Alexa May Connors. Morgan Elizabeth Cook Sather. Luke Douglas Cooper. Sammy Grace Darling. Sophia Unha David. Skylar McKinnon Davis. Catherine Lorraine Dewey. Natalie Josephine Dodds. Jack Raymond Donahoe. Ian James Duane. Ryan Alexander Ellison. Joshua William Epps. Allison Jane Foley. Thomas Foley. Lillian Maya Forbes. Kayla Renee Foy. Gabriel Jose Fraga. Musa Ben Omar Guy. Alexander Louis Giacone. Maxwell Isaac Goldberg. Yeah, Gabriel Greenberg. Madeline Sarah Greaves. Elliot Crane Gross.
Come all the way up. Come all the way up. There you go.
Muhammad Adam Getty. Anna Hanako Galache. Roy Hananel. Catherine Arwen Abair. Casper Bay Hoffman. Ed Holland the Third. Jordan Samantha Hoppy. Sydney Lauren Horenstein. Basim Horshaw. Gordon Stanley Houston the Third.
Come all the way up.
Elise Sarah Duchesne Ingram. Ruby Mae Kaufman Rosengarten.
Come all the way up.
Samuel Coburn Kazat. Aiden August Kempf. Finn Augustus Kent. Cindy T. Kim.
Terrence Kassan Lewis Jr. Eric Lillard. Jared Emerson Lawner. Emma Neneviller Lord. Imran Ludini. Claire Isabella May. Anne Catherine McCammon. Yeah. Abigail Teresa McDonald. Kieran Robert McDonald. Eric Ross McLaren. Aiden Quinn McLean. John Francis McNamara. Natalie Ann Newhouse. Zachary Asher Platt Brannon. Ethan Shane Rappaport. Noah A. Riccardi. Dior Milan Rogers. Phoebe Jordan Habadonk Rotundo. Justin Becker Rubin. Patrick Thomas Ryan IV. Ben Satz. Benjamin Samuel Schlegel. Lily Jenyun Selko. Adam Henry Sirota. Leo Benjamin Shack. Inara Jayla Shell. Amanda Catherine Sheward. Dylan Z. Sices. Margot Galia Sissel. Lily Rose Smith. Taylor Lynn Snowden. Sean Snyder. Diego Carol Spielman Rodriguez. Bailey Donna Stovall. Charles William Schwartz. Amanda Jean Thompson. Kaya Tanique Thorne. Tabo Dotetsi. Isaiah James Waddington. Blair A. Walters. Lydia Hope Wilcox. Harper Teresa Blair Will. Destin Nathaniel Willis. E. Tucker Wolfson. I would ask the graduates of the class of 2021 to move your tassels from the right to the left. And let's celebrate, friends. Let's give the FCS class of 2021 another round of applause. Thank you.